Can shoes really make you a better athlete? For $250, Nike claims these shoes can make you run 4% faster.
Yeah, skeptical too. For years, sneaker companies have been marketing shoes with claims they can make you be like Mike, no like Bo. And I'm still confused about the purpose of the Reeboks with the pumps.
Time out! Gotta get pumped.
I'm talking to researchers, a sports therapist, and doing an experiment of my own to see if shoes can truly improve your performance and to see if any shoe is worth that kind of cash. Generally speaking, sneakers are made up of three components: the upper, the midsole, and the bottom. They're designed to cater to the low dealing door, so sneaker makers sometimes experiment with grip strength, cushioning, and a lot of other things to ensure better performance depending on what sport the shoes are designed for.
So basically you have an upper, or the cloth part that wraps around your foot, and you have a lower, or a sole, that is made up of an insole, which is the removable insert typically that you have in your shoe, the midsole, which is where all the structure and the cushion come, and then the outsole, which is what makes contact with the ground.
Originally released in 2017, Nike claims their shoe, the Zoom Vaporfly 4%, uses what they call responsive cushioning to ensure more efficient running. The shoe has a carbon plate extending from your heel to your toes that stores and releases energy with every stride to propel you forward. This, in theory, can shave 6 minutes off a 3-hour marathon or about 8 minutes off of a 4-hour marathon, which equates to 4% speed improvement over other Nike shoes, hence the name. While Nike's Zoom Vaporfly 4% sounds groundbreaking, it's far from an original concept. Both Reebok and Adidas have released spring-loaded running shoes that use added polycarbonate or rubber to help you run faster or more efficiently. Inspired by all-terrain vehicles, Reebok's ATV Plus 19 promised stability through mud, snow, sand, and grass. And geared towards the casual runner, the Adidas Spring Blade used 16 blades of polymer that act like springs to give you added propulsion every time your shoe hits the ground. Here's a fun fact. At one point, sneaker innovation got so crazy that the NBA had to ban a pair of kicks. APL's Concept Ones were banned just before the 2010-2011 season because they used 4-foot compression technology, which its creators say could give players an additional vertical leap of 3.5 inches. Eventually, the Concept Ones were allowed back in the league, but its creator's sake, it could still be banned from competitive play in some schools and some professional leagues. Although Nike's claims for the sneaker might be outlandish, there is some truth behind them. An independent New York Times analysis used public records to compare more than 500,000 marathon and half marathon running times. The analysis found runners in Vaporflies ran 3-4% faster than runners wearing any other shoe, and more than 1% faster than the next fastest running shoe. Since I have trust issues, I wanted some more proof. So we visited New York Dynamic Neuromuscular Rehabilitation and Physical Therapy Clinic, a state-of-the-art outpatient clinic that specializes in gait analysis, to run some tests. Basketball, baseball, and football all require hand movements that are not affected by your sneakers, so we strictly focused on running to see the correlation between footwear and athletic performance.
Gait analysis is a study of human motion during running or walking. It checks kinetics, which are forces exhibited during running, checks kinematics, which are joint angles. We can also check muscles, what muscles do. We can check pressure. We can also check your form and your neuromuscular control.
With markers placed on my feet, knees, hips, and chest, I walked, ran, and jogged while a computer tracked my motion. We tested two shoes, a New Balance designed for running and some Chuck Taylors, which are pretty much some average shoes. By the way, athleticism, not one of my strong points.
Like, this is really, it's really bad running.
Results showed that while running in the New Balance sneaker, my feet experienced less pressure, possibly due to cushioning. I also had more gait line stability, but while this would provide me more comfort in a race, it didn't really improve my running abilities.
I see the same poor kinematics, excessive hip abduction, pelvic drop, trunk instability, crossover, everything I saw before. Nothing really changed, and nor can it change with any kind of different shoe.
While this might sound like a trivial issue, a lot of studies have been done on this subject. To improve performance, some advocate for stiffer bottoms, while others call for lighter shoes, but researchers are pretty split. The truth is, everyone's foot structure and function is different, so no one solution is going to be right for everyone. It goes without saying that if you want superior athletic ability along with shoes, practice makes perfect. Shoes can vary in price depending on the research and development behind them. Then there are also some that use superior, higher cost materials.
What we found is comfort is probably the most important thing. So if you're comfortable in a shoe and you feel good in a shoe and you have confidence in that shoe, you're gonna perform better.
So if you want to buy shoes to improve your performance, don't base your decisions on the price tag, brand, or celebrity endorsements. Just make sure they got the right fit and feel and you'll be set to cross the finish line. Possibly. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's episode of What the Facts. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, make sure you hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. Got a weird body science question? Shoot your shot, drop a comment below, and who knows, we might cover it. Be sure to catch more of this season every Tuesday.